because it speaks to this man's character and his honor. He's so beat up, a man could hardly walk. When they threw us, we'd both been solitary confinement for about a year, and moved us to another camp, and he was right next door. I couldn't tap on the wall to him because there was a walkway between us, but I could see out, I could see his door. But even as far away as this gentleman standing right here, I could look over at him. And the reason I could is I found a little piece of wire and burned a hole in the door. I could sit on the floor leaning against the door. Wasn't much to look at inside, it was pretty nasty. So I just leaned against the door and I just looked out there all day, see my buddies coming and going. And the guy closest to me was this fellow so bent up, so broken physically. Sometimes he had to put his hands on his knees just to stand up straight. And through tapping on the wall of my neighbor on the other side and passing some notes, I found out his name, Navy Pilot. I forgave him for that. And of course I could see his terrible injuries. And he'd come back from an interrogation or from a torture session, beat up, trying to hold his head up the best he could. And as the guard was messing with his lock to his door, he'd have him in, he'd look over at my door. I'd take my fingers and I'd sort of wiggle them under there so he'd know I was there. And he'd muster up the strength to stand up, give me this big old John McCain smile and a thumbs up. We're going to beat these people. We're going to win. We're going to go home with our honor. And he did it. You know, I tell the story, of course, and I've had people say, well, a thumbs up. That's no big deal, is it? I said, well, I guess it depends what's behind it. I said, you know, you take a piece of steel, and you don't heat it, you make it into a sword, you might as well be messing with silver putty. But you take that steel and you temper it, and you make it hard, and you make it dependable, and you can do a lot of things to that tempered steel. Well, he's been tempered in the car and the heat all day. I don't think it's a small thing.